Welcome to today's program on Love with me, your presenter, Meg Ibi. Our topic for today is on abusive marriage. And the question is it advisable to remain in abusive marriage or not? And with us on the studio today are three wonderful speakers. Chief Jumbest Omorogeva, a notable palace chief in the society. You're welcome to the studio, sir.
Thank you very much.
We also have with us Pastor Mrs. Joy Osayende, a minister of the gospel and a motivational speaker. You're welcome to the studio, ma'am.
God bless you, ma'am.
Thank you. Also with us is a mother and a motivational speaker, Mrs. Enua Ero Obasuye. You're welcome to the studio, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Thank you, ma'am. As earlier said, our topic for today is on abusive marriage. We're going on a short break, and after the break, we'll commence. Please don't go away. Today is on abusive marriage. Over to you, Mr. Jumbest Omorogeva. Is it advisable to remain in abusive marriage?
If actually, at the beginning of the marriage, none envisage emotional disturbances.
Mm-hmm.
But something has to crop up along the line that will make somebody to be witch hunting you inside your marriage. Then I think that in this regard, I will advise the woman to sit down properly and ask herself first. Then carry it forward to the husband and ask why the abuse is being of imminent. Then if at the end of finding out the solutions and you find out that it is something you beyond bearable condition,
mm-hmm.
then you invite the right channel, which are your parents. You take the matter straight to your parents for advice. They will now tell you, look, this is how it was in their time and this is how it was not in their time. It is good to endure, or rather not to endure. But when it comes to the physical aspect of it,
physical abuse.
Yeah, I would not encourage that because I also have a sister.
You have a
and
daughter.
In the future, I have daughters. So I wouldn't want somebody to
abuse
introduce a corporal punishment into a matrimonial living.
Mm-hmm.
But when it is emotional, somehow the cause is something you can always ameliorate. You can change it. Because if you sit me down and ask me why I decide not to, let us go down.
Mm.
Now, I have a wife at home. When we started, we were very sweet.
Mm-hmm.
At a time, I may have erred somehow, unknowingly. Rather than making it clear to me that my husband, this is or daddy or what you call it, this thing is not done. Maliceness started. She started keeping maliceness in the room, in the house. Then it's beyond imagination.
Yeah.
Then that is unknowing. I don't know.
Yeah.
Now, if she have come out and tell me what you did is what I don't like, immediately I will appeal it so that we have peace in the house. But as I begin to compile it, I did one on Monday, one on Tuesday, continuously, you begin to pile it to yourself. You are not only injuring me, but yourself.
Of course.
So it is better we be outspoken in our marriage. Tell your companion that what you've just done is against the ethics of marriage. Then he will tell you, oh, I'm sorry if I've done it knowingly or unknowingly. What we really want is apology.
Mm.
When you have been able to apologize and make your wife feel, it will not repeat itself again.
Yes.
I think there is absolute calm in the house.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Over to you, Pastor Mrs. Joyce Ayande. What's your take on this?
First of all, I would say just as examine yourself very well first to see if you are really the cause of the abuse. So if you check it very well that you are not the cause, then call your husband first. Both of you can sort things out. By the time you do it once, twice, you know, talk it to the man and with prayers and everything, I believe that God will intervene in the situation. But when it comes to violence, that because I've heard of many cases, even here in Italy, that a man tried to struggle his wife to death. It happened live. So in that kind of situation, maybe a lot of people have come in
to the situation.
It's a situation. Pastors have prayed. Mm-hmm. Many people have talked. So tomorrow I have voice that the woman will need to just
step aside.
Yes, with the children. So then let's see what God is going to do. I'm not talking about that voice yet,
mm-hmm.
but just step aside first in the marriage.
A break.
Just a break. Maybe separation.
Separation.
Yeah. But if it has not come to that estate, I believe that you can still sort things out.
Over to you, Mrs. Obasuyi. Is it advisable to remain an abusive man?
My advice is that when a spouse, it can be the man, the husband, it can be the woman, is emotionally abused. When you talk about emotion, yeah, it means
feelings
of somebody, of the man or of the woman.
I don't care attitude.
Yeah, you have trampled on the feeling of the woman. This often occurs from the men. Okay, I'm not saying that the women are perfect.
Mm-hmm.
We wives also have our weak points. Now, what are the issues that comes up when you talk about emotional
abuse?
Is when, for example, the husband doesn't see anything good about the wife anymore. You know that something is fishing. Okay, you come back from home, you are moody. The wife that you used to see as a queen is now seen as your enemy. From there, you begin to treat her as if she's the witch that is troubling your life. You see any small thing, you start using names. You start shouting on her. You use words that will make her feel bad inside. You see, one thing is that emotional abuse, when you compare it with physical abuse, physical abuse, the bruises or the injury are seen. But emotional abuse, the pain, the scars are inside.
Inside remains.
Okay? When you insult your wife or your wife insult the husband, it goes from here, it goes to the memory.
Mm.
And it remains.
It remains.
It's easier said than done. Just forgive now, let's go ahead. Yes. But the damages you have caused inside, no one will be able to, you know, heal her except God Almighty. Okay? It's not advisable for couples to involve in this
emotional
kind of
abuse.
Yeah, it's so painful and it can damage somebody's self-worth.
Mm-hmm.
You no longer feel accepted, you are disdained, you are confused. And the reason for this is that the man wants to lord over you. He wants to make you feel inferior.
Mm-hmm.
That is the reason. Me, I'm against a woman dying in marriage.
No support of it.
The thing you have to do next, if you see that it's also coming into or resulting into physical violence, physical
abuse.
Violence, combat, abuse. Because I have seen a man that killed a wife out of this in Benin. In Benin, out of annoyance, boom, in the wrong place, he fell down.
So many.
Yeah, gone. Yes. So the thing, what I'm supporting here is that she should give it a break. Let people come in. At least you should have somebody that you too will listen to.
Yeah.
Even among his friend, if you know that he has a good friend, you go to him.
For advice.
For advice. From there, you know, give a break, give a gap. No matter how the word we are going to use, a break or gap is separation.
My dear moderator, let me come here. I want to disagree with a point Sister just made here.
Okay.
You see, I cannot boast of a pure Christian due to my personality or whatever, you know. But I used to know that the world today, a larger percentage of women are Christian. And one of the reasons why you see this moody and so on going in marriage is always caused by women. And in fact, I want to quickly say, you said men, when you said men. But the area I want to counter here is just, you said somebody insult you, probably on the probability, somebody, your husband insult you and the thing went through here to the memory and the memory goes straight to the heart. And nobody can cure it except God. That shows you are a Christian. But if no apology from your husband can cure that, then it become a permanent cause.
What if he doesn't apology?
On the potency we go. Yes. Like we three of us are speaking on the same point. That
yes.
Initially I said, let this woman go. Confront your husband. You came from work, I gave you food, you did not eat. And in the process of confronting you, you begin to tell him, my mother is a witch, my father is a witch, which is abnormal to hear. Now goes down. Then the solution is still not yet found. Not until you are able to convince him to know why all of a sudden the queen you said become the evil in the house. He wants to tell you, yes, I was coming from road today. I heard that you went to open market and you discussed with one of your friends that your husband is not good at bed. Let us use that. He's not good at bed. And that message now come to me and I think I will be very, very wide. Why I left you at home and not left you for discussion and all the bad to come and I only hear your story in the open market. That one can cause that. But if at the end, on this way or that way, you are able to convince me and I say, I'm sorry, because that is, wait, I want to get this point, because the point you make is what I'm saying, that if it has already gone into
it death, can still go out with apology.
That is it. If it can, I want to call it that. It will go because we have agreed to remain, and so we shall remain.
Yes,
you understand?
Yes, Chief, it can go.
Okay.
When on the ground that you and you apologize. Marriage without unforgiveness can never
live
out. Marriage, in husband or wife, we didn't come from our parents or our home. No, with so sweet.
No.
One day or the other, once one apologize, including me that is here, if I have not forgiven my husband for certain things he has done. You know, he will now come and say, "Ah, honey, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hurt you. I'll forgive and forget." We are still going, and the love is still was stronger and stronger.
Okay.
So in marriage, there ought to be forgiveness.
Okay, I'm still coming up. There's nobody from outside that can come and cause problem between you and your husband about emotional. If you have not opened up, if I don't tell you, madam, me and my wife get problem,
you will not know
what is it. It is when I sell the cards to you, you now play it the way you want it.
Yes.
And when I reveal it, it becomes a problem in my house. He working pastor, me no tie in matana. He might get better. The girl I woman only he want baby. He might do pastor.
Thank you very much. You just blessed the man of you.
Yes. Jesus.
You have something to control.
Okay. For the concerning the emotional abuse,
the
most of the things that leads to it is unforgiveness.
Yes.
By the time your husband offend you and you keep piling it up, piling it up, even the Bible make it clear. How many times will somebody offend you in a day? He says 70 times 7. And nobody can offend you 70 times 7. So if you take your husband, no matter what he said, I know you can resolve it, but first of all, let forgiveness
stand
in your marriage. By the time we forgive one another, know that after your husband has said something, you will go inside, begin to think of it often, over and over again. By the time you begin to play it off, meditate upon it, that is where it now leads to emotional abuse. But by the time you learn how to forgive immediately, because there's no way your child can offend you, that you say he's no longer my child, or a 2 years old child, or a year old. You say, okay, you offend me, I'm going to drive you out of this. It's not possible.
No.
So you take your husband to be one of them. Immediately he offend you, if you have the spirit of forgiveness, then you forgive immediately, then move on with your life. Then later, because I always tell people around me, it's not one issue. When you have issue with your husband, then you begin to discuss it at that moment. You cause more harm.
Give it some days.
Give it a break. Then even if it can even be after 2 months.
Yes.
then you not come up with the issue.
Your mind is relaxed.
Then your mind is relaxed. Then your husband cannot hear you clear. He cannot feel your pain at that moment.
Yes.
When you learn how to forgive everybody around you, then you see that life is very easy.
And you'll be light.
You'll be light.
Yes.
All those problems that we see here and there, you see, you find yourself that just think that you are just living alone.
Yeah.
That nobody offend. That is the life I'm living. Just don't look at anybody. When you say something, just dust it as if it has not happened. There are sometimes I was telling my women, if you don't have anything to say in that moment or there's problem, maybe somebody used a word on you, or you just go to the toilet, just walk straight to the toilet, remove that thing in your heart, flush it, that as if it didn't happen.
It didn't happen.
Exactly.
Then you just let go. You see yourself, you free and be happy. Then by the time you discuss it, when you tell you sorry, then you know that the pain is no longer there. Then you see everything will go smoothly. And if your husband, at times your husband refuses to eat, your approach, the way you approach the issue, it will touch him whether to eat or not. Not that your husband just come home, he doesn't want to eat, and you don't know what the issue is. The man is frowning. After observing the man for some time, you yourself, you started frowning.
So,
so by the time you know it, it will grow. It will not affect everybody. But by the time your husband refuses to eat, then you just, you with a smile on your face, then run to the man. What have happened this time around? What have I done? Please forgive me or come and eat first before we talk about it. They say when you present it to the man, but then you start just came. Now he said don't want to eat. Okay, no problem. You will see. Then before you knew it, problem. So by the time you resolve it, how you talk to your husband matters a lot.
Thank you very much, Pastor Mrs. Joyce Anyende. To the best of my knowledge from what you said, presentation is very important in marriage.
Yes.
The way you present issues. Talk it over with your husband. And if it's beyond you, you seek advice from the spiritual father. Thank you very much. We've heard from Mrs. Joyce and they're going on a short break, and after the break, we'll be rounding up. Welcome back. We're going to treat some message from our viewers at home. This is from Mrs. Helen Uja, Verona. Mine is verbal abuse, calling me names in public and at home when there is misunderstanding. Man, should I start to call him names or do the same in order for him to feel the pain? Over to you, Mr. Jones.
Before we treat the verbal issue on that issue, we first of all have to redress the root
of,
that problem. There's this saying that now first of all, go look at this framework of the family. The pride person of the house, the head of the house is the man.
Yes.
And we as an African, we like pride, the men. We want to be the Lord. And we like respect. And when we are being respected, I think the men at the same time, when we have our respect in our palm, we are the what do we call
like
it? We are the babies of the family, of the marriage. But a situation when you rub your level with me in the house. Now,
to captain,
I say, edit, sit down there. I want to address you on an issue. You said no. What issue would you have to? Then we are on the same parallel level. I said, when you quell up your power with me in the house, it gives problem to the marriage also. So the aspect of the abusive, verbal abuse, there must be reason for it. Nobody wakes up in the morning and starts insulting the wife. God punish you, you are crazy, you are mad, you are witch, you are that. Now, let us know the reason why for that. Now, let's go down. Like yesterday, my wife came back from work. Ah, madam, you got late yesterday. I bet leave me the work where I work today. You did it. Then we go to bed. And the following morning, I decided to approach her again on the same issue. Mama, you came home late yesterday. What were the problems at place of work? Rather than coming down to my level to let me know. This same thing we are saying now is just, we treated the men part for the first issue.
Yeah.
This one is from the women aside now. Now, rather than approaching me calmly and say, oh, that yesterday, the man I cleaned their house, they did not come back on time to open the door for me, and there was no soap, no soap, nothing to clean. That was why I came back and looked moody. So, sorry. Should I insult you? Why should it? So, but for the man who just left home, who does not know the worth of a matrimony, or does not know the value of his home, went home outside to the public, and they pour insult on the wife, based on little argument from home, then it doesn't make him a man. Mm-hmm. And he should be cautioned, and he needs counseling also. That's so true. I don't support that. But somehow, first of all, we must find the cause for verbal abuse.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, madam.
Over to you, Mrs. Obasuyi. This one is from Oja Park, Villafranca. Please, mommy, mine is emotional and sexual abuse. He doesn't have single respect for me. All he does is what suits him. My opinion doesn't count at all. What will I do, man? I thank God for this program. I know it will go a long way to help marriages at the edge of collapse. Bless you, man.
Okay, thank you. My advice for this lady.
He said emotional and sexual abuse. No consent. That's no sexual consent. Abuse.
Okay. My advice for her in the area of emotional abuse, she, like what Chief said, the primary solution
to it,
the foundation
must be checked.
The person have to check, the woman have to check herself. That is what I do. Let me check, am I the cause
of this
harassment, embarrassment, shame, you know? If you have checked yourself and you see that you are not the cause, because there are many people born, let me use that word, born with bad character, can be found in the men,
can be found in the women, both sides.
You might be unlucky to jam men like that, you know. And some people just love abusing people, running down somebody. They take
joy in pride in it.
Yeah, they are so happy doing it. And to them,
making that person feel isolated.
Yeah, to them, they have not done anything wrong.
Just inborn.
Yes, inborn. They've not done anything wrong. And I cannot say the fault is from this woman or from the husband, okay? Because I'm not with them, okay? But I want to say that there are many women that are really innocent. And there are many, many, I said many before now, many that use their hand to cause problems for themselves. So I will advise the woman to check first. And the other side of it, how can a husband be abusing the woman sexually? She should also check herself if she always satisfies the man. Okay? If she doesn't satisfy the man, and the man, because when the tension comes, I think Chief should be in the position to answer that.
Why should I say that? Okay.
To answer that, Isabella, let me just go the link to. Because it has never happened in my home, you know.
As a man.
Because the man is on the verge of, because he's bad for the company.
Yeah. So that when the heart is there, you are not there for him, you know.
And you can lead to abuse. Is your today, wife?
Next morrow. Pain, you are telling me no?
No.
It can
cause abuse.
It can cause abuse. But if it's the nature of the man,
then it's
because there are many men that are sexually
inclined.
Yeah, the urge is always, you know. Yeah. And you don't know the condition of the woman, because some will say, I have fever. You say, it doesn't matter. So far, I just take care of me first before we treat malaria. You know, so in everything, I will advise her to be patient, because there is no marriage that is
a bed of
roses, you know, and two of them have to talk iron out issues themselves,
Marriage is enjoyable, not to be endured. Mm-hmm. By the time you endure a marriage, you are not doing the perfect will of God. The children suffer for it. So, another advice that before you get married, study your spouse very well. Knowing whether you are doing the right thing or the wrong thing. Don't look at the money. Don't look at the handsomeness of the man or the beauty of the woman. Always look at the heart of each other. It matters a lot. So what you could not take in the relationship, I don't think in marriage it will change. So if you're the spouse that you are about to get married to, when you are in a relationship, you see that this thing cannot work or you cannot change this thing after marriage. It's better to withdraw. So when you are in a relationship, there are so many things that you see that I cannot take from this man. You have to think and pray if you can go into this marriage. But when you find yourself there, please be patient, be prayerful, and God will always meet you at the point of your needs.
My advice for our women in marriage is perseverance. And two, they should seek the face of God. Three, they should always know that their husband is not from their own family. These are two people from two different families coming together to learn. Yes. So they are learning. Both are learning. Yeah. Marriage institution is a continuous institution where you learn. After death that it comes, the lecture becomes an endable one. Then to the men, we should always learn to respect our wives. We should always sit down and give ear to them. Let us hear from them because they are not second citizens. They are part of the marriage.
Over to you, Mrs. Obasi. What advice do you have for marriages at the edge of collapse?
Nobody pray for
divorce.
Nobody pray for problem in marriage. But for that area of problem, once in a while, it occurs. My advice is that couples, husband and wife, there should be agreement. Agree with one another. Love one another. Wife, respect your husband. Be submissive. According to the book of Ephesians 5, from verse 21 to the end, please be submissive. And the husband too should love your wife. That is what the word of God says. Because a man that loves the wife, you just play your own part first. And what you will gain from your wife, it will amaze you. I pray that God Almighty, whosoever is going through bitterness in marriage, God Almighty will turn it around, remove all those bitterness and add sweetness to it. You will not labor in vain. So just hold on to God. Be patient and learn to forgive one another. Forgiveness.
We've heard from our guests in the studio. And I believe their words of advice has inspired someone out there. As they say, be transparent in your marriage. Let there be total agreement. Submit to your husband. And husband, love your wife. And that brings us to the end of today's program on Lot with me, your presenter, Meg Ibi. A special thanks to our guests for honoring our invitation. And to our audience, our viewers at home, we say thank you. And to our sponsors, we say thank you. See you same time next week for another wonderful and interesting episode on this program.